Welcome to Agape Family Church, where God is the head and love is at the center of all we do. We thank you for joining us today for our online worship experience. We are, of course, continuing to see a great move of God in our midst during this time of prayer and fasting. And as we are wrapping up this week, we thank you for coming through and being with us for this Thanksgiving service. Greetings coming through from Pastor Anne as well on this day. And we're trusting God that he's continuing to minister in your life. He's at the head and all is going to be well. We want to acknowledge our lead pastors, Pastor Maurice and Pastor Joyce Khadebe, and we pray God to continue to use you as the hands and the feet of God in our generation to minister to our lives and to impact us in the way that you are doing. We pray that you'll continue to be in health and that the Lord will prosper you and your family. We thank the leadership of the church for your continued support for the work of God and the work that you are doing in ensuring that these messages, they come online and we continue to minister, even though we are, of course, not gathering at this time. Listen, we will be updating you on all the developments as regulations begin to open up. And soon we look forward to being in fellowship with you. But in the meantime, we continue to encourage you to limit all the unnecessary social mixing at this time and the observing of all the non-pharmaceutical protocols that are in place, even with the new variant that is in circulation at this time. We believe that if we just adhere to that and we do our part, the Lord will do the rest and we will be kept. We're praying for you, those who have been bereaved and lost your loved ones, you're closest to our hearts and closest to our prayers at this time. And as the pastorate in the church, we are trusting God to be the peace beyond all understanding in your life at this time. Join in with us in praise and worship.
Keep at me, oh, he will not suffer.
Indeed, we give thanks to God not only for this day, but in this season when anyone with a good mind, Paul says, needs to recognize that we are not of our own and we are the making of God's hand. And we thank the Lord above all, who is the source of all the good things and perfect gifts that we see in our life. I'm glad today that we have a day designated through this prayer season that is a day called a day of thanksgiving, because every now and then you ought to pause and remind yourself to be thankful that work and life and reality can happen and weigh so heavily on upon us that sometimes it diminishes the reality of how grateful and truly you ought to be for the good works that the Lord has done in your life. And so it's in that spirit that I would like you to bow and be in prayer with me as we prepare to hear what God would desire and design for us to hear today. I bless the Lord at all times. Your praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in you. The humble shall hear and be proud. Oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. For indeed, God, you have done enough today alone for us to thank you for even the rest of the year that is still ahead. And Father, as we gather here online today, that you might speak to us and set our hearts and our minds and give us a grateful heart and a soul that realizes that you are the source of everything good and every perfect gift in our lives. It's in the name of your Son, Jesus, we pray. Amen. So without assuming you know what I'm already going to say, before I say it, I'm going to invite you once again to reflect on what I already spoke to on Friday, but we'll take it a little bit further on this Sunday morning. So if you had the privilege of being with us during the prayer time on Friday, well, you have the privilege of hearing it again. I want us to talk this morning about some of the things that we can do, and this is a major issue, particularly in the time we're living in, on how we can walk in the miraculous while we are alive in this planet. I'm sure if there ever was a time in your life where you want to walk in the miraculous, it is now than ever before. We want the miraculous to show up in our lives right now, right this minute. I'm really excited that we're able to talk about the miraculous power of being locked in a lifestyle of gratitude. Help me tell your neighbors who are watching and who are online with us today that our theme and our topic today is how to be locked in a power of gratitude to release the miraculous. Giving thanks to God. Others say giving glory to God in order to release the miraculous power of God. The miraculous power of thanksgiving. I related on Friday how when I was pressed by illness during the time of the pandemic, the Lord pressed upon my spirit to begin to sing intentionally songs about thanksgiving, songs that give God the praise. Not just sporadic, but intentionally setting time aside to sing all on my own songs that give thanks to God. As I was doing that, I started noticing an anointing coming on in my time with the Lord and the Holy Spirit revealing some things about this illness, but also some of the demonic forces that were particularly on the attack while I was ill. And then I started to witness some miraculous things begin to happen around me and my family. To this day, we still marvel at what God has done and what he did for us. So something so simple as thanksgiving, yet I believe with all my heart that it carries miraculous power, that it is the supernatural power that has been invested in thanksgiving, that when you take time to intentionally give God thanks, something begins to happen. When you do that, you will begin to see things happening in your life. I believe that to be locked in a perpetual life of gratitude is one of the vital keys for the release of the miraculous. Thanksgiving is not only an occasional thing, nor is it a spontaneous acknowledgement of a good deed at that particular time. It's not the singing of praises, not the clapping of hands, but here it is. Thanksgiving is a nature, a lifestyle, a real and continuous appreciation of the acts of God in one's life. That when that lifestyle is demonstrated in your life, I believe you will begin to see the miraculous power of God at work in your life. It's a situation where you look at the things that God has done in your life, not just now on the day that he does it, but this has now become a part of your life. Thanksgiving has become a part of your life. It's a continual appreciation, and that's giving God the glory. So we looked at a very familiar scripture on Friday, which I'm sure is familiar to many of you who are online today. Thessalonians, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18. That's where we were. Not out of familiarity, but in the context of what I have just said. So we can see that this was the plan of God all along concerning our lives, mine and yours. It says in verse 18, in everything, give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. He didn't say give thanks for everything, but he says in everything. Now, somebody would say to me, what do you mean I ought to give thanks for the pain? I ought to give thanks for the accident? I ought to give thanks for the loss? No, no, no. That's not what it says. But it says no matter what you're in other words, whether it is something good, whether it is something bad, that because you are locked down in this nature of real and continuous appreciation of the acts of God in your life, you will continually thank God for his wonderful acts. That even in the midst of a bad situation, you're thanking God for what he did 2 weeks ago. That even in the midst of a painful situation right now, you're going to muster up enough strength to say, Lord, I'm grateful for what you've already done. For some of us, God doesn't need to do anything more. He's already done enough for us to be extremely thankful for the work that he has done. The New Living Translation of that verse says, be thankful in all circumstances. Now, you know how you are, right? You're in the middle of a certain situation. And when you're in the middle of a certain situation, the temptation is to complain. But here it is. When you are in the middle of a certain circumstance, that is when you really need the miraculous to show up. That is when you need to be thankful for that circumstance. That's why God has done so much in your life that you can always pull from your file and you can say always, Lord, thank you for what you have done in my life. I am thankful. I woke up in my right mind. I woke up with my health. I thank you that my immunity is strong. I thank you that my oxygen levels are normal. My needs are met. I'm out of debt. I have plenty more to put in store. My family is blessed. How are you blessed today? I mean, how God has encouraged you, right? It's a continual appreciation for the acts of God in your life. He says, be thankful in all circumstances, for that is God's will for your life. Now, that is powerful. That is powerful, you know? Everyone is looking for the will of God about their lives. And here he says, well, there it is. This is God's will for your life. You will be thankful in all circumstances. That is the will of God for your life. Now, are you doing that? Is that true in your life? Are you grateful in all circumstances? Or is there temptation to murmur, grumble, and complain a little bit? Now, often I have to take myself and put myself on check, right? And say, wait a minute, God has been good. Good to you, good to your family. The murmuring, the grumbling, the complaining, you cannot be complaining like this. He says, for this is the will of God for you who belong to Christ Jesus. Well, you belong to Christ Jesus, right? You are made by him. You are made in his image. You have the life of God in you, right? Well, he says, you, the will of God for your life is that you be thankful in all circumstances. You know, God has got to have a reason why that's the will of God for your life right now. And I mean, God is the most purposeful being ever. Now, when he says operate like this, you'll be doing yourself a great favor if you make sure that you operate that way. God is waiting for your gratitude to perfect his plan and purposes for your life. And I'm sure we all want God to perfect his plans and purposes for our lives. Well, start walking in gratitude. Let's look at Luke 17 and let's read 13 to 16. I want to show you something there because Jesus expected them to come back to say thank you when he was dealing with the lepers there in Luke. He expected them to come and acknowledge the act of God in their lives. That when God does something, there's an expectation from heaven that we should acknowledge that and give God the glory for what he has done. Verse 13 to 16, and they lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. These are the guys who had leprosy. So when he saw them, he said to them, go show yourself to the priest. And so it was that as they went, they were cleansed. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, returned and with a loud voice glorified God and fell down on his face at his feet, giving him thanks. And he was a Samaritan. Now, I said to you on Friday, the reason why that was mentioned, that he is a Samaritan, it is because the Samaritans and the Jews, they did not like each other at all at the time. There was this division that was happening between them. But I tell you that when God shows up to do something for you, you forget about racism, you forget about division, you just become grateful for what God has done in your life. The Bible says even this Samaritan gave thanks to this Jewish Jesus. Tell you what, that's what I'm believing for this nation today, that there is going to be a miraculous power that will break down divisions, that will be so powerful in our situation, that will dissolve hate and dissolve all the racism. When thanksgiving is involved, it opens the door for the miraculous. And so what happened for this guy was he went back to say thank you, and Jesus say, well, now be made whole. Now be made whole. Now you know, for a person with leprosy, they could probably be missing a finger, they could be probably missing a limb, something of that nature, something would be missing. But now, because he came back to say thank you and to give God the glory, God, thank you for the mighty act that you've done in my life, then the Lord says, now be made whole. The others didn't come back. Yeah, they were cleansed on their way, but I'm sure they're still missing something. But when he came back, Jesus said, be made whole. In other words, if there's something missing, something broken in your life, be made whole. Listen, I thank God when the Lord shows up in my life and he does something fantastic and great. But I just don't want to neglect giving him thanks and giving him glory. But I tell you what, there is something that happens if you take the time intentionally to give him glory for the act that was performed. Now that's what we spoke about on Friday, and that's what we are about even today, showing continuous appreciation of the acts of God that have happened in our lives. Jesus expected them to come and acknowledge the work of God in their lives. See, there was the first touch, but that was not enough. They just got cleansed. But then there is the second touch that is needed to put a seal on your miracle. And I believe that the second touch to put a seal on your miracle comes when you show up with gratitude, when you show up in thanksgiving. Let's take it further now today. Let's look at Malachi. Malachi chapter 2. We read verse 1 and verse 2. Okay, this was in a time, understand, of the law, especially here. It was the time of the law and the prophets, from Judges all the way through to Malachi, that would be the prophets. Now, look at it. It says, "And now, O ye priests, this commandment is for you." Now watch what it was about, even way back then, right? He says, "2, if you will not hear, and if you will not lay to heart," lay what to heart? "To give glory unto my name." Oh, he's saying, if you don't hear it, and if you don't lay it to heart to show appreciation, to give thanks and to give glory unto my name, saith the Lord of hosts, he says, "I will even send a curse upon you, and I will curse your blessings." Wow. Why? Well, he says, because they didn't take it to heart. Yeah. "I have cursed them already because ye do not lay it to heart." Lay what to heart? To show appreciation, to give glory to his name. Well, it was serious then, right? We must remember that under the law, any violation of the law meant that you had to pay the price. There was always a result or consequence for violating the law. One of the things that got my attention was this was so serious that they would even talk about this in the Old Testament, that thanksgiving was a serious deal, that giving glory to God was a serious deal. What it is that there is something that can come forth because of our thanksgiving. What is it that can come forth because of our thanksgiving? Well, I believe it's the miraculous power of God at work in our lives. You see, Jesus was never left stranded because he utilized the key to bring a solution. What key? I believe the key that he used was the key of appreciation. Here it is. Jesus demonstrates here how he used thanksgiving that causes the miraculous to be made available. Look at John 6:11. Some of you are familiar with John 6:11, where there was a 2-piece fish dinner that showed up, but that wasn't enough to feed the people that were there. What do you do with so little when there is a potential 20-something thousand people there, right? Look at what Jesus did. Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, what? Right. So we need something miraculous to happen here, because there is just 2 fish and 5 loaves. So what does Jesus do? So we needed a miracle to feed all these people. What does Jesus do? He takes the loaves and he gives thanks. I'm telling you, man, I believe that thanksgiving is the door to the miraculous power of God. The miraculous power of God comes through thanksgiving. It says Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, look at what happens. He distributed to the disciples, to them that were set down, and likewise of the fishes, as much as they would. They ate and they were full. Look at the multiplication of this food. Well, how did it start? Jesus was never stranded. "Father, I thank you." And as a result of the appreciation and the miraculous shows up, and everybody got something to eat. While we are in John, let's look at John 11:41. You see it again, how Jesus utilizes the key of appreciation to bring about a solution to every situation. He says, they took away the stone, right? This is Lazarus. He had died. Now remember the famous statement by his sister, if you were here, my brother would not have died. And Jesus was like, "Girl, you don't even know who I am. I am the resurrection and the life," right? Look at what he says in verse 41. "Then they took away the stone from the place where the dead was laid. And Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, 'Father, I thank you that you hear me.'" Wow. There is thanksgiving again. Jesus utilizing the key, thanksgiving, to bring forth the miraculous, to be the solution to situations he encountered. Now, if Jesus was utilizing thanksgiving to bring forth the miraculous, you and I can do the same. Jesus gave thanks in seemingly hopeless situations. I need you to hear that. He gave thanks in seemingly hopeless situations. You see, I know the pandemic has been rough on your job and has been rough on all of us and how you're going to pay your rent and all that. Listen, this is not the time to murmur, complain, or to be angry. It's the time to have a flashback and look at what Jesus has done in your life. I believe this is the time where you will begin to give God thanks in the midst of seemingly hopeless situations. I believe that things will begin to happen because you do that. And I need you to understand that the miraculous power of God is made available when you begin to give thanks. I believe thanksgiving will gain heaven's attention. Now, how many of you would like heaven to give attention to something that you're going through right now, right? How many of you would like heaven to pay attention to your situation? I believe thanksgiving will gain the attention of heaven. I think about King David. Now, David was a dude who rarely, if any, lost a battle. And so when you look at somebody so accomplished, you probably want to dig into his situation and find out what he was doing, right? Consider King David then. Terrible opposition, challenges during his reign, but he never lost a battle. Well, what do you suppose was the reason? The miraculous power of God was always at work in his favor. Always. The miraculous power was always at work. You know, David wasn't like just, you know, some amazing fighter, right? The miraculous was at work. I mean, even when you read the story of David when he was a teenager, the supernatural power of God was on that stone that killed Goliath the giant. It was working on his behalf. Now look at what David does and what we find in when we read the book of Psalms. It was fascinating for me to discover. 10 times a day, David was in the sanctuary. But only 3 of those days were for prayer. Yeah? Only 3 of those days were for prayer. You'll find that in Psalm 55, 17. He says, evening and morning and at noon will I pray and cry aloud, and he shall hear my voice. Now, the remaining 7 times was for appreciating the faithfulness of God. Psalm 119, verse 164. So 7 times appreciating the faithfulness of God. Notice, it was intentional that David 7 times out of 10 was going in to show appreciation to God. Remember in the beginning, I said the key word here is, I believe, intentionally showing thanks to God, intentionally giving God the glory. Let's consider also the apostles, right? Signs and wonders, following their preaching in the name of Jesus. Now, they were warned to preach no more, and they were wont to preach no more, particularly in that name. But rather than complain and murmur, they had a prayer meeting. Man, the miraculous came out of that prayer meeting. Look at it. It's in Acts chapter 4. We're going to read 24 and 31. They were like, you better not preach anymore in that name. And they had a prayer meeting. And in this prayer meeting, you can imagine they were giving God the glory, giving God the praise, thanking God and giving him glory for his mighty acts. And then Acts 4:24 says, and when they heard that, they lifted up their voices to God with one accord and said, Lord, thou art God, which has made heaven and earth and the sea and all that is in. I mean, they are giving glory right there for his mighty acts, the work that he has done. Then look at verse 31. Then the supernatural begins to show up. And in verse 31, it says, and when they had prayed, the place was shaken. Oh, where they were assembled together. Look at that. Thanksgiving goes up and the miraculous power of God shows up. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and they spake the word of God with boldness. The miraculous shows up. I tell you what, the plan of the enemy is to get you more involved in murmuring and complaining and less involved in giving him thanks and giving glory to his name. And we can continue in Acts. And if you look at Acts 16, 25 and 26, Paul and Silas began to give God glory, began to praise God. This praise is able to turn around captivity. I don't know what area of your life you find yourself captive in, but there is a way to turn captivity. It is when you take time to give God thanks, you give him glory, you praise his name, God will turn your captivity around. Where are you today? I believe that there awaits you the miraculous for your life. The supernatural is ready to minister to you. But I believe that we as believers, we've got to come to a point where we say, Lord, your will and not mine. Lord, I'm going to operate in the will of God for my life. And the will of God for my life is that I will give him thanks in all circumstances. I pray that you will meditate on this. Go over these scriptures, because I believe that in the middle of everything that's going on, I know emotionally, it's like, man, when is this going to be over? I get it. But you have a choice. You can choose to allow your emotions to dominate you and begin to lead you into murmuring and complaining, or you can choose the will of God for your life. And that is thanksgiving. Let's pray together. Father, thank you. Thank you for the miraculous work you continue to do. Thank you for the gift of salvation. Thank you, Father, that even right now, those who are listening under the sound of my voice have been touched and convicted by your word. And somebody would like to give their lives to Jesus right now. And Father, we pray that wherever they are and wherever they are, that Father, you would forgive their sins. You would cleanse them from all unrighteousness. Give them the assurance and the confidence that today they are saved, that they have got eternal life and the gift of life that comes from Jesus. And that, Father, you will continue to minister into our lives in this situation. And that, Father, you will give us a heart of gratitude, that our souls will be awakened to the many great and miraculous things that you continue to do in our lives. In Jesus' name, we pray and we thank you. Amen. And I really believe that the Lord has been speaking strongly on this question of thanksgiving. And you will go and apply this, and you will see great things as you prepare yourself for the miraculous power of God to be made manifest in your life. Don't go away, because straight after this, you've got the kids' zone. But most importantly, today, as we are breaking our fast, we will be getting into a time of communion. Pastor Maurice is standing by to lead us in a time of communion together. So gather your family around, gather the communion around, and let's fellowship together as we celebrate the goodness of the Lord in our lives. And as we remember the perfect work that he did for us on the cross of Calvary, and we believe that the Lord will nourish, revitalize, and enrich our lives through this fellowship today. The Lord bless you, the Lord keep you, and the Lord shine his face upon you. Do enjoy the rest of your day. In Jesus' name, amen.